Hello guys, today our topic is all about the inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, so at the end of this lesson, you will be able to graph the six basic inverse trigonometric functions and illustrate the domain and range of the inverse trigonometric function. Okay, so before anything else, let us recall first the basic concept of inverse function. Okay, inverse function. Okay, so inverse function, so na-discuss na po yan sa subject natin sa general mathematics. Okay, so inverse function is a one-to-one function. One-to-one function. Okay, so a function said to be one-to-one if it passed the horizontal line test. So, during dun sa discussion na sa function sa general mathematics, diniscuss po doon yung dalawang test. Yung horizontal line test, tsaka yung isang vertical line test. Yung vertical line test, tinitest yung isang graph kung ito ba ay function or hindi function. Okay? So, ginagamit po yung vertical line test. Then, yung horizontal line test, ginagamit po to test if the function is one-to-one or not one-to-one function. Okay? So, the function has an inverse if and only if it is one-to-one. Okay? So, dapat one-to-one siya para mayroon siyang inverse function. We are going to connect the concept of inverse function in graphing the inverse trigonometric function. So, mayroong word na inverse trigonometric function. Okay, so in order to sketch the graph of the inverse trigonometric function, we first restrict the domain of the trigonometric function. Okay, because some of them is not one-to-one function, or each of them is not a one-to-one function. So gagawin po muna nating one-to-one function, yung trigonometric function, para magkakaroon ng inverse trigonometric function. Okay, so for example, ang sine function, yung restricted domain niya ay from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Okay, so yung restricted domain natin, so ibig sabihin, ito yung starting point ng graph, then ito yung endpoints ng graph. Okay, so for example ng cosine function, restricted domain niya is from 0 to pi. Okay? For cosecant function, so inverse po yan ng sine, di ba? So therefore, pares lang po yung restricted domain nila. From negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Then, for the secant function, so pares lang po ha, reciprocal po siya ng cosine, therefore, pares lang po yung restricted domain. From 0 to pi. Next, tangent function. So, restricted domain is from negative pi over 2. Okay, for the tangent function, the restricted domain is from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Okay, next is cotangent function. The restricted domain is from, okay, this time, although cotangent is the reciprocal of tangent function, but the restricted domain, hindi po sila equal. So, kung yung tangent is from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, cotangent is from 0 to pi. Okay? Okay, so, let's start. Start with the inverse of sine function. Okay? So, we're going to graph the function y is equal to the inverse sine x. It also can be written in the form of y is equal to arc sine x. So, equal lang po yung dalawa. Pag wala kayong nakita ng ganyan, nakita nyo to, ibig sabihin, inverse po yan ang sine. Okay, so in graphing an inverse sine function, first we are going to graph the sine function. So i-graph muna natin yung sine function. So inverse of sine x, so yung sine x po yung i-graph muna natin. Okay, so in our previous lesson, we discussed how to graph the sixth trigonometric function. Yung sine x po natin, yung sine function po natin, meron pong period na 2 pi. So ilalagay ko muna po dito. This is 2 pi, I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is 2 pi. Hindi po yan ha. So this is pi, this is 3 pi over 2, this is pi over 2. Okay, so isang cycle po yan. Okay, so we start po sa center. So mayroong maximum point na 1, mayroong minimum point na negative 1. Diba? So maximum point, center, minimum point, back to the center. Isang cycle po yan ng graph ng sine function. Okay, this time, maglalagay rin po ako ng graph to the negative side of x. So if this is pi over 2, this one is negative pi over 2. This is negative pi. This is negative 3 pi over 2. And this is negative 2 pi. Maglalagay rin ako ng point. So center, minimum, center, maximum, then center. Okay, so this time, gagraph muna ako ng broken line sa kanila. Okay, broken line lang muna yung igagraph ko sa sine function. Papakita ko lang po bakit may restricted domain. Bakit kailangan ng restricted domain? Para magraph ang inverse function or inverse trigonometric function. Okay, so meron tayong restricted, diba? From negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Okay, so para maging, gawin natin 1-to-1 function yung trigonometric function para magkaroon ng inverse trigonometric function. Okay, magdodraw ako ng solid line from the restricted point. So this is, okay, yun na yun. Okay guys, kailangan po ng restricted kasi po pag kinontinue ko po yung graph, to the positive infinity, then kinontinue din po ito to the negative infinity, then bagsak po sa horizontal line test. Okay? So, tingnan nyo po ha. So, kung continue po, paglagay ko po ng horizontal line, ay gamit tayo ng iba para makita po. Okay, for example, ito yung graph ng sine function natin. Pag continuous po siya, hindi po siya 1-to-1 function. Pag test ko ng horizontal line, it intersects more than one point doon sa mga graph, sa graph ng sine function. So, sabi nga, a function has an inverse if and only if it is 1-to-1. So, dapat 1-to-1 lang. So, makikita nyo sa dito sa graph ng sine function, only from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 lang yung pwede. Pag kinontinyo, hindi na po siya 1-to-1. So, dito, pag test mo, kahit saan dyan, 1-to-1 po yan. Okay po? So, this is the graph now of sine x, the given function y is equal to sine x with the restricted domain from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Okay, so this is x-axis and this is y-axis. Now, this time, we're going to graph the inverse sine x, or the function arc sine x. Okay, so we will be using this technique to graph the graph of the inverse sine x. Okay? Ito lang yung pinaka-discarte para madali. Ito yung center. Mark lang natin yung center. Then mark po natin yung restricted value, yung restricted domain. So this is from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2. So this is x-axis and this is y-axis. Okay? Nandito yung pi over 2, nandito yung negative pi over 2, nandun yung positive 1, nandito yung negative 1. Okay, in order to graph the inverse of a trigonometric function, we are going to interchange the x-axis and the y-axis. So it means yung lahat ng value ng x-axis mapupunta po sa y-axis. Then yung mga value naman po sa y-axis mapupunta naman po sa x-axis. Okay. So ganito lang po yung pag-graph. Tuloyan na po natin. Graph na po natin to. Okay. Graph na po. So this is y-axis. This is x-axis. To graph the inverse sine function, we are going to interchange the x-axis and the y-axis. Yun na po yung mangyayari. So kung nakita nyo po, ito po kanina, ito po yung y, yun po yung x. So interchange, yun na po yung mangyayari sa graph natin. Okay? So ilalagay ko lang po ha. So upward, up yung curve. Then, okay, sige. Copy natin yung graph. Okay. Yun na yung graph. So this time, ito na yung magiging x niya. Then ito yung magiging y niya. Pero yung mga value po nito, value po ng y natin kanina sa baba. Then value ng y-axis natin, value po ng x-axis sa baba. Okay? Level muna natin yung mga value nila. So this is, so ito magiging pi over 2 na po. This is pi over 2. Yan, pi over 2 na po yan. And this one is from negative pi over 2. Ito po ay magiging positive 1. Then this one will be equal to negative 1. Okay? So kung mapansin nyo po dito sa original function, so yung 1 po nasa y, yung 1 tsaka yung negative 1 nasa y-axis. Sa inverse po, yung 1 tsaka yung negative 1 nasa x-axis na po. Okay? Interchange po yung value. Okay. So, yun lang. Yun na yung graph ng inverse sine x or the given function y equal to arc sine x. Now, we're going to determine the domain and range of the inverse sine x. So, domain and range. So, the domain is the set of all values of x. Then, the range is the set of all values of y. So, titingnan na, sa domain, titingnan natin yung mga value ng x na may graph. Yung walang graph, hindi kasali. Okay, for example dito, ito yung negative side ng x. So, ito papuntang negative infinity. Then, ito naman papuntang positive infinity ng x. Then, sa baba po nito, ito yung negative infinity ng y. Then, sa taas naman, ito yung positive to the positive infinity ng y. Okay, so we'll be using, para sa domain, we'll be using the vertical line. So, pagpapunta, assume na nasa negative infinity, papunta, walang graph, saan po nag-start yung graph? So, dito mapansin natin na nag-start po sa 1. X, I mean, this is negative 1, sorry. This is negative 1, this is positive 1. Okay, so this is negative 1, this is positive 1. Ulitin ko lang po ha. So, from negative infinity, wala po. Saan po nag-start yung graph? From negative 1. Negative 1 is included. Pag included po, square bracket po yung gagamitin natin. Pag hindi po included, parenthesis po yung gagamitin natin. Okay, then, saan patungo? So, continue yung graph, hanggang positive 1. So, yung domain is from negative 1 to positive 1 lang po. Included pa rin po si positive 1. Nandun po si positive 1. Okay, yun po yung domain niya. Okay, next for the range. So, yung range naman po, yung titingnan po natin, yung y-axis. So, let's say, mag-start tayo from the negative infinity, pataas. So, papunta doon, wala pang graph. Saan po nag-start yung graph? Sa negative pi over 2. Negative pi over 2, may graph? Yes, mayroon po. So, included. That is negative pi over 2. Then, continuous yung graph. Saan papunta? To positive pi over 2. So, yun na yun po yung range niya. Okay? The domain of the inverse sine x or the domain of the arc sine x is from negative 1 to positive 1. Then, the range is from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Yun lang po. Okay, so next we are going to sketch the graph of the inverse cosecant function. Okay, so example, we have the given function y is equal to the inverse of cosecant x. So pwede rin other term arc cosecant x. Okay, so to be able to graph the inverse cosecant function, first is we're going to graph the sine function. Okay, so sine function po muna. So this is the graph of sine function. So sketch natin yung graph ng cosecant function. So cosecant function is the reciprocal of sine function. So this is the graph. So pagpunta dito, wala na pong graph yan, di ba? Kasi restricted from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 lang. So hanggang dito lang. So yung reciprocal niya, mag-i-start rin po dito papunta po sa taas. Yun na yun. Then sa baba po, mag-i-start din po dito, pababa rin po. Okay? So, mayroon po siyang yung cosecant function, mayroon pong mga vertical asymptote. So, yung mga na-point na nasa midline ay mga vertical asymptote po yan. Okay? So, including 0 is a vertical asymptote. Okay, so this one is the graph of cosecant function. Now, so we're going to graph the inverse cosecant x. So this one is the graph of cosecant x. Okay, so we'll be using this technique to simply graph the inverse function or inverse trigonometric function. Start dito. So nandito yung center. Identify palagi yung center. Ito yung graph. Pataas. Then, ito naman, pababa. So, this is pi over 2. This is negative pi over 2. So, yung mga vertical asymptote niya ay nasa pi. Dito, this one is pi. This one is negative pi. Okay? So, including 0. 0 is the vertical asymptote of cosecant function. This is x-axis. This is y-axis. Okay na po? Okay, so next, paplat na po natin dito. We're going to interchange the x-axis and the y-axis. So, yung center nandito po. Okay? Then, yun na po yung magiging graph niya. Okay? So, ito na po yung start po siya dito. Start din po siya dito. Okay, graph natin ha. Ito yung starting point niya. Then, papunta po siya dito. Sa kabila naman, ito yung starting point niya. Papunta po siya doon. Okay? Next, yung mga label natin yung mga vertical asymptote niya. Ito po ay vertical asymptote. Then this time, naging horizontal asymptote na po. Zero is the naging horizontal asymptote na po siya. Kasi naging inverse na po. Okay? So yung horizontal asymptote, vertical asymptote kanina, this is pi. Yung isa naman po ay negative pi, then zero. So therefore, this one is pi. This one is negative pi. And this one is zero. So, ito po, starting point po nito pataas ay pi over 2. So, therefore, this is pi over 2 and this one is negative pi over 2. Okay? This one, papunta po dito ay positive 1. Then, ito naman po ay negative 1. Okay? So, yan na po yung graph ng inverse cosecant x or the graph of the given function arc cosecant x. Now, we're going to determine the domain and range of inverse cosecant x. So, the domain. Okay, so kung mapapansin nyo po, this one, this graph, can be extended. So ito po ah, x-axis po yan, x-axis, then this one is y-axis, y-axis. So this graph can be extended into the negative infinity of x. Then also this graph can be extended to the positive infinity of x then. Okay? So domain is the set of all values of x. So from negative infinity, so kung extended yan to the negative infinity, so if, therefore, start tayo from the negative infinity. So pag infinity po, parenthesis po yung gagamitin natin. So negative infinity, saan po papunta? Papunta po siya sa negative 1. Negative 1. Included or excluded? So negative 1 is included. We'll be using the square bracket. Okay. Greater than negative 1, wala pong graph. Wala pong graph dito. Saan ulit yung graph? Nasa positive 1. So union po tayo. Union. So positive 1 included? Yes, included. So from 1, saan papunta? So extended na yan into positive infinity. So positive infinity. Pang infinity, parenthesis po yung gagamitin natin. So yun po yung domain ng inverse cosecant x. From negative infinity to negative 1, negative 1 is included, union to positive 1, then to positive infinity. Okay? Then for the range, y-axis naman po yung titingnan natin. So let's say, start tayo dito from negative infinity. Wala pong graph. Pataas po tayo. Wala pa rin graph. Saan po nag-start yung graph? Sa negative pi over 2. Included? Yes, included. Square bracket. Negative pi over 2. Saan papunta? Taas tayo. Pagdating po sa 0, 0 is the horizontal asymptote. So, ibig sabihin po, yung graph po natin, hindi po magta-touch sa horizontal asymptote natin. Approaches lang po yan. So, ibig sabihin, hindi po included yung 0. So, we'll be using parenthesis. Then, greater than 0, mayroon na po. Union po tayo. Pero sa 0 again, horizontal asymptote, hindi po kasali. 0, greater than 0, mayroon na pong graph. Saan po papunta? May graph yan. Papunta pong pi over 2. So, pi over 2 included? Yes. Okay. So, this is the domain and range of the inverse cosecant x or arc cosecant x. Okay? Okay. So, next we have the inverse cosine function. Okay? So, we're going to graph the function y is equal to the inverse cosine x, or also can be written in the form arc cosine x. Okay? So, again, in order to graph the inverse cosine function, we're going to graph first the cosine function. So, the y is equal to cosine x. Okay? So, mayroong restricted. Lagay na po natin yung restricted, ha? So, from 0 to pi. Yung restricted po ng cosine x. So, this is 0. So, 2 pi po yan, ha? 2 pi po, di ba, dati? So, kung hanggang 2 pi, nandito po pa sang 4. Ito yung 2 pi. So, this is 3 pi over 2. So, this is pi. So, this is pi over 2. So, yung restricted is from 0 to pi. Okay? Maximum point, 1. Minimum point, negative 1. So, yung cosine, mag-i-start po sa maximum point. Then, down to the middle. Then, down to the minimum point. Okay? So, hindi na po natin i-graph yung sobra. So, ito na lang po. Okay? So, okay. So, yun yung graph ng cosine x na may restricted domain from 0 to pi. Okay. So, we're going to graph the inverse cosecant x. So, again, we'll be using this technique. So, this is x-axis. sisuway axis. Ito yung center, indicate natin yung center ha. Then ito po yung graph ng cosine x. Okay? So nasa pi po ha, pi. Pi po yung nandito. Then the graph of inverse cosecant x, ito na po yan. We're going to interchange the x-axis and the y-axis. Yun po yan. Okay, ayusin lang po natin ha. Okay, so ibig sabihin dito yung graph mag-start. Pababa. Okay? End point. Point. Okay? Then, ilalabel na po natin. So, this one, nandito po yung pi. So, nasa taas na po yung pi. So, this one is pi. So, nandito na po yung 0. 0 po ito. Okay? So, this is, so this one is positive 1. And this one is negative 1. Okay? So, next, the domain and range of inverse cosecant x. So, the domain, so yung titingnan natin, so this is x-axis, this is y-axis. So, all values of x. So, dito, wala. Saan nag-start? From negative 1. Negative 1 is included. Included po. Continuous yung graph. Saan yung papunta? To positive 1. Also, positive 1 is included. O, yun na yung domain niya. Next, yung range. So, start tayo dito. Ito yung y-axis. Negative infinity, walang graph. Saan po nag-start yung graph? Doon po sa 0. 0 is included. Yes. Saan papunta? Continuous yung graph. To pi. So, hanggang pi lang po. Pi is included. Yes. Okay. So, yun lang. The domain and range of the inverse cosine x is from, yung domain is from negative 1 to 1. Then, yung range is from 0 to pi. Tapos. Okay? Next, we have the inverse secant function. Okay? So, we're going to graph the given function y is equal to the inverse secant x. Or also, can be written in the form arc secant x. Okay? So, ganun pa rin yung diskarte. Bago mo mag-graph yung inverse secant x, ingagraph po muna natin yung secant x. Para mag-graph yung secant x, mag-graph ka muna ng cosine x. So, secant x is the reciprocal of cosine x. So, this is the graph of cosine x. So, lagay po natin. Pag secant na, mayroon na po yung mga asymptote. Mayroon pong vertical asymptote. Yung mga nasa midline. So, this is midline. So, ito po yung mga vertical asymptote niya. Ito, midline din to. Ito yung mga vertical asymptote. And this one is also the... Ah, hindi ito. Ito. Ito yung vertical asymptote. Diba? Continuous yan. Punta. Continuous po. So, ito yung mga midline. Okay? So, yung... vertical asymptote, nasa po, nasa 3 pi over 2, nasa pi over 2, din sa kabila is nasa negative pi over 2. Okay? Okay, so graph na po natin yung secant x. So, kung ito yung cosine x, then yung secant x is the reciprocal. So, bawal na po doon. So, ibig sabihin yung reciprocal nito, papunta po doon sa taas. Then, hindi po siya magta-touch sa vertical asymptote natin na pi over 2. Then, sa kabila rin, ito po yung magiging reciprocal niya. Okay? Okay, so let's graph the inverse secant x. So, again, we'll be using this technique. So, ito yung center niya. Mark palagi yung center. Yung x-axis, then yung y-axis. Okay, so this is pi. So, ito yung starting point ng graph ng secant x. Yun ito yung starting point ng secant x. Okay? Then, ito po yung mga vertical asymptote. Vertical asymptote. So, yung nandito, negative pi over 2. And this is pi over 2. And then, 3 pi over 2. Okay na po? Okay, so let's grab the inverse secant x. So, we're going to interchange the x and y axis. So, ito yung center kanina. Tama? O, yun na yun. Yung magiging graph niya. Kaya, ayusin na lang po natin. Okay? So, dito po yung starting point. Papunta po dun sa taas. Okay? Ito yung center, di ba? So, next, nandun. Ito po. Then, papunta po siya dito sa baba. Okay? Okay, next. Yung mga vertical niya na naging horizontal asymptote. Okay, label na lang po natin. Okay. So, ito yung mga horizontal, vertical na naging horizontal asymptote. So, hindi po magta-touch yung graph natin dyan. Then, ito po. Then, also this one. Okay, kanina, yung sa baba po niya, yung negative side ng x, na naging ngayon, negative side ng y, is negative pi over 2. This is negative pi over 2. So, this is pi over 2. This is pi over 2. Then, this one is 3 pi over 2. Okay? So, this one is negative 1. Negative 1 po yan. And this one is positive 1. Okay? So, this is x-axis and this is y-axis. So, x and y. Okay, next. So, we're going to determine the domain and range of the inverse secant x. So, the domain. So, kung mapapansin nyo, this graph can be extended to the negative infinity of x. Then, ito naman, ganun pa rin to the positive, papuntang positive infinity po yan. Can be extended to positive infinity. Okay, so start, negative infinity. So, pag infinity nga, parenthesis po yung gagamitin natin. Negative infinity, saan papunta? Hanggang negative 1. Negative 1 included? Yes, included. Negative 1. Greater than negative 1, wala pong graph. Ibig sabihin, walang domain. Saan ulit nagka-graph? Doon po sa positive 1. Union po tayo. Positive 1 is included. Hanggang saan? The positive infinity. Okay? So, the domain is from negative infinity to negative 1. Union to negative positive 1 to the positive infinity. Okay, next. For the range. So, start tayo from the negative infinity. Okay? So, walang graph, walang graph, walang graph. Saan po nag-start yung graph? Sa 0. 0 is included? Yes, included po yung 0. Then hanggang saan? Approaches to pi over 2. Vertical asymptote, naging horizontal asymptote, yung vertical asymptote natin kanina. So, hindi po magta-touch sa horizontal asymptote yung graph natin. So, from 0 to pi over 2, kaso lang si pi over 2, hindi included. So, parenthesis po yung gagamitin natin. Then, greater than pi over 2, meron na po. So, yun yun tayo. So, mag-i-start po yung notation natin sa pi over 2. Then, hanggang saan lang po? So, this is pi over 2. This is pi. Tama? This is pi. So, pi over 2 to pi lang po. Greater than pi, wala na pong graph. Included sa pi? Yes. It is included. Okay. So, this is now the domain and range of the inverse secant x. So, So the domain is from negative pi, negative infinity to negative 1. Negative 1 is included. Union to positive 1. Positive 1 is included to positive infinity. Then the range from 0, included 0, to pi over 2. Pi over 2 is not included. Then union to pi over 2. Again, pi over 2 is not included to pi. Okay. Yun lang. Okay, now let's have the inverse tangent function. Okay, so we're going to sketch the graph and determine the domain of the function y is equal to the inverse tangent of x, or also can be written in the form arc tan x. Okay, so ganun pa rin yung technique. Bago mo mag-graph po yung inverse tangent x, igagagraph muna natin yung function na y is equal to tangent x. Okay, so may restricted from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. So actually, yun na po yung vertical asymptote ng tangent function. So, 0. So this is negative pi over 2. This is pi over 2. Yun na po yung vertical asymptote. Okay? One, this is negative one. Okay. Okay, so this is y-axis. This is x-axis. Okay, graph na po natin. So, pataas po siya. Then, pababa po dito. Okay? So, this is the graph of tan tangent x. So, hindi po ito magta-touch sa vertical asymptote natin na pi over 2. And also, this one, hindi rin po magta-touch sa vertical asymptote natin na negative pi over 2. Okay? So, let's graph the inverse tangent x. So, ganun pa rin yung technique. Okay. Center. And this is x-axis. This is y-axis. Ay, sorry. Okay, so yung vertical asymptote natin, nasa pi over 2, then nasa negative pi over 2. Then ito yung graph ng tangent x. Okay na po, center natin. Okay, so graph po natin yung inverse tangent x. We're going to interchange the value of x axis. The x-axis and the y-axis. So, ganun po yung mangyayari. Okay, isin lang po natin, ha. Ito yung center. So, yung isa. Okay. Yung isa naman. Okay. Yan na yan. Okay. Okay, level lang po natin, ha. So, yung mga vertical asymptote, ngayon magiging horizontal asymptote. So, this one, extended po yan, ha. Extended po yan. So, this is pi over 2, and this is negative pi over 2. Okay? So, ito na yung ngayong x-axis, ito na ngayon po yung y axis. Okay. Next, for the domain and range. Okay, for the domain and range. So, this graph can be extended to the negative infinity. Then, continuous po. Wala pong putol hanggang positive infinity. So, therefore, the domain is from negative infinity to positive infinity. Okay? So, ganun lang kasimple yung domain niya. Okay, next, range. So, y-axis. So, negative infinity, wala pong graph. Saan po mag-start yung graph? Pagdating po dito, naging horizontal asymptote yung negative pi over 2. So, hindi po magta-touch yung graph, pero kasama po siya. Doon po mag-start yung notation natin. Hindi kasali, from negative pi over 2. So, So, greater than negative pi over 2, mayroon akong graph. So, hanggang saan po? Approaches to positive pi over 2. So, hanggang positive pi over 2, ganun pa rin, hindi rin magta-touch yung graph natin sa pi over 2 kasi horizontal ascent siya. So, hindi siya included sa range. Okay? So, the domain of the inverse tangent x is from negative infinity to positive infinity. Then, the range is from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Okay, ganun lang. Okay, so, next, let's have the inverse cotangent function. So, last na po ito. So, we're going to sketch the graph of the function y is equal to the inverse cotangent x, or can be written also as arc cotangent x. So, ganun pa rin. Bago natin mag-graph yan, i-graph muna natin yung cotangent x. Okay. So, cotangent x, mayroon po siyang restricted domain from 0 to pi. Okay. From 0 to pi. So, this is 0. Then, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Andito yung pi. Okay. This is pi over 2. This is 3 pi over 4. This is pi over 4. Okay? So, cotangent. So, ito po, ito yung magiging vertical asymptote niya. Pi, then yung 0. Okay. So, mayroon po siyang 1, negative 1. Ito yung pinaka-center niya. So, positive pi. Ito po. Then, this one. Okay. So, i-graph na po natin yung positive cotangent x. So, mula po dito. Pa-center. Then, goes po. Okay. So, this is x-axis. This is y axis. Okay. So, ito na po yung graph ng cotangent x na may restricted domain from 0 to pi. Okay, next. Okay na. So, let us graph the inverse cotangent x. So, ganun pa rin yung diskarte natin. So, ito yung center. Ito yung x-axis. Ito yung y-axis. Ito po yung mga vertical asymptote. Pi, tsaka yung 0. And ito ngayon yung graph ng cotangent x. Okay. So, the graph of inverse cotangent x will be look like this. So, yun na yun. Kita. Okay, usin natin ha. So, ayusin na lang po natin. Unti ka ng mairis. Ayusin natin ha. Center. Okay, yun na yun. Yun na yung graph. Okay. So, tanggalin na natin. Okay, then level na po natin. Ito po ay mga dati vertical, ngayon horizontal asymptote na po yan. And this one is also the horizontal asymptote. Okay? So, ano yung horizontal asymptote? Nasa pi So this one is 5, then this one is 0. Okay, now for the domain and range. So domain, this one can be extended. So this is x-axis, this is y-axis. Can be extended to the negative side of x. So from negative infinity, continuous, papuntang positive infinity. Okay? Yung range, so 0, 0 is not included. Kasi horizontal asymptote, saan na papunta? Papuntang y. Kaso si y, si pi, puntang pi, hindi kay y. Puntang pi, si pi, hindi included. Okay? So yun na yun. The domain of the inverse cotangent x is from negative infinity to positive infinity. Then the range is from 0 to pi. Okay? So doon po sa module po natin, mayroon pong correction doon ha. Pa-correct na lang po dito. Mayroon pong kunting mali yung aklat. Okay? So that's all. Again, thank you for watching.